us think. Let us think and plan wisely. I agree, the old gymnasium is woefully inadequate. And I, too, want athletics to have its proper place in our school program. But because this bond issue does so little for us, I am in favor of voting down this bond issue, and then at a later date, let's present a new bond issue, which will provide both for this gymnasium and for sufficient funds to reconvert the old gym and the old stage into the necessary classrooms.
Well, there we have two votes. Bill Shout is for the new gymnasium, and Mrs. Flint is against it. I'm wondering what some of the rest of you folks are thinking. Well, here we have an answer. Let's hear your opinion.
I'd like to deviate just a little bit from the question and say this, that the rural communities are the backbone of America. That, I believe, is undisputed. And here's an important thing that I think nobody will dispute either. Our small communities and the rural communities, if they don't get behind some program that will further their town, what will happen, we'll have more centralization of government. And that is something I don't think anybody wants. To give you an illustration, we have our local school board that serves free of charge. We, wherever we help in the federal or state government, we send our money in there. And by the time we get it back, in administrative costs and as we saw in our income tax, it's been pitiful the way that's been handled. We only get a small portion of it back. I think that that alone would indicate that we should handle our own situations here. And then going back to what Mr. Hammond said in regard to the growing town, I happen to be a builder, and of course I know wherewith I talk, we have at least 30 or 40 new homes since 38. Now that would indicate a very healthy growth. Also, we have, I think, around 50 or more commuting workers out of Slater. Not long ago, there were 2,000 realtors that met at a real estate meeting, and their final prediction was that by 1960, the trend would be so tremendous towards the rural areas that it would startle us if we knew it. In other words, the trend is towards coming out to the country and probably puttering out in the garden a little bit and maybe even picking a few eggs.
Well, we're talking here in terms of a problem that seems to me we're just not looking at properly. I mean, we're talking of a growing town. There are 25 or 35 new houses in the last few years. And still, we say, we can take this old gymnasium, which will provide three or four or five or possibly six small classrooms, and have enough room. We can build a gym for $35,000, which we'll have money left over. We talk about Ankeny, which is spending something like $750,000 and is running out of money. We're going to build one for $35,000. We have an assessable tax valuation of about $825,000 in our district. It seems to me that our first problem is to get to a place where we can get more money to work out a bigger program. We talk about these consolidated schools in our area. Well, they were built 35, 40 years ago. They were set up on a basis of horse and buggy days when you couldn't go out over 4 or 5 miles. We've progressed in that. And still, we have each of our little country schools, our little rural schools out here. I don't mean 4 mile squares. I mean our little consolidated areas. We can go out 20 or 30 miles now just as easily as we could go 5 miles in with a team and wagon. And still, we're hanging on to this thing. I think it's bigger than we realize. It seems to me that this program is entirely inadequate. Our funds just won't reach.
Well, your point is, then, that thought should be given towards enlarging the school district.
I think we have to.
Before you start a construction program at all, is that the point? Well, how does somebody else feel about that?
Here we have. I quite agree with Bill on that. I just paid my taxes today for 1951, and it brings this to mind that a few years ago, most of you remember the bad 30s, that we can tax ourselves too far, too, that we'll have a chance of losing them. It's very easy to say you built, what, 20 new houses in town? Well, perhaps them 20 houses in town pays about the same taxes that a couple of farmers pay. And it seems to me that in a district as we have, as Bill says, so small, that a few farm families have to pay half of the deal and the town the other half, it's getting a little too rough. I happen to farm 80 acres and try to make a living off of it. I've made a living off of it. But on that 80 acres, I got to dig up $440 to pay taxes, which I believe about two-thirds go to school. Actually, for last year, it worked out something like this, people. Every day the school opened last year cost me $1.49. Every day. The town people, which in a lot of cases made more money than I did, I see a few around here that work at a good trade and contracting business, etc. If we can take the published tax deal that they put in the Slater News to show how much the town families paid in comparison to country families, the average town family, believe it or not, paid the total sum of 27 cents a day compared to my $1.49. A lot of people tell you, well, I got a going business, I should pay. Well, I suspect that is true. But actually, I'm using my small business to try to make a living. It don't make any difference whether a guy's in the grocery business or what he is. I don't believe a property tax should go so far as to practically take his business away from him to run his school.
Do you agree that the district should be enlarged in order to expand?
The district definitely should be enlarged, but what I'm going to try to make a point here that the state has come along with some help. We do get some state aid. And I do feel that these small districts can't operate unless we get real large, that is, not real large, but much larger than we are. We've got to get some taxable value to go along with it. Another thing we must have, instead of saddling all property tax on school, as I say, we're getting a little late now, school taxes should really come from ability to pay. Let's say one-third income, one-third sales, catch some of these guys that's riding free, and one-third property, some such a scale.
Well, thank you, and if someone else got an idea on that subject, John. Here, you have the floor.
Well, I'll tell you, gentlemen, I think we're hitting this ball for a long time. The reason I'm against the gym, I think we better start working on our legislature. They say they can't consolidate these districts without a dictatorship. There must be some law in the book. I know a little incident in an awful election year. I know it in our mail alley here in the Hartzell change. We had a back guy with 200 yards with four mail boxes on it. We wrote into him. He sent back. Nothing's doing. We can't do it. The next year, the mailman says, go ahead and write in. This is election year. See what happens. I sent that letter in the middle of May, and I've got back in time to accept it before the final is June. Therefore, that's where I feel that, Jim, something should be done to the legislature and get things straightened out so we can have help and do this job right.
That's just the point that I tried to make in my talk. That, I don't think that my opinion is we don't want the legislature into this thing. I venture to say that if you folks stir up the legislature enough and get them to take this thing over, you'll be the most sorry people that you ever dreamed of. Because there again, you're going to have them take away some of your own privileges. And the best privilege we've got is to provide for our children and our own community, and both the school and the church. The rural community life revolves around your school and church, and if you think you can measure it in dollars and cents, I'll go along with you, but I've never saw anybody yet that could measure it in dollars and cents. And we are, I think, a strong enough community that we can carry this extra load, which is really the smallest portion of it. I grant that our big load is our operating cost. But there again, I think that if you all think of it in a real common sense manner, you'll realize that nobody's going to come in here and give us anything. Just the same way if you expect the government to come in here and give us anything, there again you're badly fooled, because the government don't give anything away. Don't kid yourself.